Hello, I'm Cal. Welcome to another video in the Improve or Reuse Your Tired Laptop series. Great title, eh? Here is a link to the first video where I explain the reasons why and where to check to see what improvements you can make to your current old laptop. Also, how to install RAM. In this video, I am going to show you how to swap out the hard disk drive to a solid state drive. If you believe the sales pitches from the manufacturers, SanDisk claim 20 times faster than a standard typical hard disk drive. Kingston claim 10 times faster than a standard 7200 RPM hard disk drive. I will support there is a huge performance increase from a hard disk drive to an SSD. I will explain this in more detail as I play the SSD installation video, just to keep this video a little bit shorter. Hard disks are old tech. They rely on moving parts to store and locate information, which makes them slow and cumbersome, and more prone to failure. Solid state drives don't have moving parts as such, hence the name solid state. There is a drive that mixes these two formats together, which is a SSHD, which stands for solid state hybrid drive, which combines a small amount of solid state, typically around 8 GB or so, along with the hard disk. These drives are faster than the standard hard disk drives, but still rely on moving parts, so still considerably slower than an SSD. Check out this video where I compare some of these different drives against each other. You will find a lot of these SSHDs in current laptops. This one I am removing is just a standard hard disk drive, which runs at 5400 RPM. The faster the RPM, the faster it performs. I have a 3 TB 7200 RPM one in my system. The main reason they are still used is for price. They offer a large volume of storage. SSDs are expensive in comparison to hard disk drives. Currently, a decent 5400 RPM 1 TB small factor hard disk drive, which is 2.5 inches, will cost around £35. A decent 1 TB 7200 RPM normal size, which is 3.5 inches, will be around the same price. A decent 1 TB SSD will be around £110. It's a big difference, 3 times the price nearly. They are getting cheaper though. Go back around 6 months and you will be paying around 50 to 80% more. Go back even further and you can double or sometimes triple that price. This is what it all boils down to really, price and whether you think the CPU is capable. I was pleasantly surprised by the performance of mine. As I said, you will have to do a little bit of homework yourself. Remember, Google is your friend. Use the search facility and ask it. Just type it in. Check to see how easy it is to open up. Someone has probably already posted a video on your laptop. On some old laptops, the hard drive and RAM will not be interchangeable. It may be a form factor that you may not be able to purchase anymore. If the tech is for sale, you need to see whether it's reasonable. You need to work out if your particular model of laptop is worth spending the money on. If you can't improve the specs, maybe we can do something else, playing retro games on it for example. If Windows 10 is too large for it to handle, we can use a different operating system. Linux is lighter and performs well. Even if the hard drive is no longer working, we can still run Linux on a USB stick. You can even play retro games on a USB stick. I will go through these in future videos, but for the moment, all I can advise you on is my laptop and on what I want to use it for. I want to use it for casual internet browsing, downloading files, a backup to my main PC. I've installed 16 GB of RAM in it already, but I would not have bought this. This would have cost about £70 new. The main thing that I wanted to do was to change the hard disk drive. I paid £22 for mine, which is a 240 GB SSD. It was on sale for £27 and I had a £5 voucher, so it didn't work out too bad for me. I didn't need a large drive for internet surfing, and once swapped out I can use the old 1 TB drive for backing up or using as an external drive. All I need is one of these USB leads to connect it to. I'll put a link in the description for this. I could have bought a smaller drive for around £20 or £25 for a 120 GB one, but the 240 GB one just seems better value for money. A larger 500 GB SSD can be bought for around £50 or £60. So it's up to you what you buy, depending on your needs and what you want your laptop to do. The makers of the SSDs, Samsung and Crucial for example, they provide software to transfer the old data from your old drive to your new SSD before you install. This can be achieved using that same USB lead. I didn't do this, I did a fresh install of Windows. This removed all the bloatware. which worked a treat for me. You may choose to do the latter option, especially if you've got files and data that you want to keep. If you are running an old version of Windows, say 7 or 8.1, you can still upgrade for free via the Microsoft site. Sometimes there is a direct option from your update screen as well. If you are doing a fresh install, I recommend that you look on your device for your Windows key. Mine didn't have one, but yours should have a sticker or a badge displaying this key. If not, there are programs out there that can help you locate this. I'm not going to go into that in this video, but I will leave a link in the description. I haven't encountered a problem with any of my upgrades. When I completed this fresh install, for example, Windows 10 verified the key using the info contained on the motherboard, but you may not be so lucky. Locate your key before you start to save you having to buy one. If you are going to do a fresh install of Windows 10, check out my previous video on how to make a Windows 10 USB drive and also the installation. If you were installing from a fresh SSD, all you need to do is insert the Windows 10 USB drive into the port, turn on the computer, and it should automatically boot to this drive because there's no information on the SSD. I will be doing some more videos on old laptops, so stay tuned. I'm particularly interested in the retro gaming side of things. But first, I want to do a comparison video on the mid-priced SSDs and the budget ones too. Hard disk drives might make an appearance, and also an SSHD, just to show the speed difference. So you could watch this before you decide to buy an SSD. Also, I want to do a couple of videos on what to install on a fresh PC, which I promised from the budget build series. If you haven't already watched those, here's a link for those. Stay tuned, please like, share, subscribe and ask others to do the same. I do this as a hobby and I do need your encouragement. Leaving a comment spurs me on, seriously, don't be shy. Thank you to current subscribers and Facebook friends for all your support and shares. And also again, people who leave messages in the comments box, I do appreciate it all. If you know someone new to computers, share my videos with them or point them in my direction. I have learning videos that are very basic for people new to the scene. I will be making more of these, there's just not enough hours in the day. Thanks for watching, I'm Calm Cal. Have a good morning, afternoon or good evening. Farewell till next time, and I'll see you later.